It's truly an honor to be here and make music with these fantastic students, musicians, human beings. We've been working very, very hard, as you may have heard. But they were patient and open and willing to change and willing to learn. And it's absolutely a joy. There's literally no place I would have rather been the last 2 days than with these musicians. Yeah. The next piece we're gonna play is actually a world premiere. So it's always a special thing when you actually hear a piece for the very first time. You can say that you were here when it was played in public for the first time. This is the piece that Voboda commissioned, and you can read about the movements in your program notes. They'll have a special character, so you should know as you listen. I think it's really beautiful, and I know it will enter the repertoire very soon. So I hope you enjoy this Suite Versailles by Brian Baumages, JMU grad, by the way. Thank you. In an experience like this, such intense experience together, I always try to bring something that I deeply, dearly love. And this next piece is one of my absolute favorite pieces, this work by Sibelius. I wish we had time to do the whole thing, but we're only doing third and fourth movement, very different characters. Third movement, you're gonna hear a lot of storm and stress. It's all about conflict. Upper strings against lower strings, loud against soft, winds against strings, B flat against A flat. There's a lot of conflict. And then right in the middle, everything stops. All the conflict evaporates. And the oboe leads us to some sort of dream, someplace where there's no problems. But just like life, problems return after that. the scherzo section continues, but it gradually transitions into the fourth movement. So there's no break between the third and fourth movement. Fourth movement has also this many contrasts, triumph, success, and also you'll hear an ostinato pattern in the cellos and violas, which repeats over and over. Wind solos are above that. That theme represents the composer's sister-in-law who committed suicide. But we break out of that, and at the end, it ends very triumphally. There's one place in the fourth movement where Sibelius actually, he always said very little about his music, but he said it should be played as if under the stars. This is the perfect place to play this music. So I hope you enjoy Sibelius' Second Symphony, Third and Fourth Movement.
Thank you.
And now, as Monty Python would say, and now for something completely different. This next piece, probably, I'm guessing, most of you have never heard. I had an undergrad orchestra conductor who was Japanese, and he introduced me to this piece. It's just simply a lot of fun. Has a lot of Japanese folk songs that which would be very familiar to Japanese people. The opening one is one that children sing when they're playing a game where they bounce a ball. You'll kind of hear that. The middle section is a flute solo, and the song that she's singing is the song a bride sings on her wedding day. It's very sorrowful because in these ancient Japanese times, you know, when you marry, then the wife leaves the family. So it's a song of sorrow in a way, but very beautiful. And then, the ending is, again, completely different than that. So thank you so much for coming. I want to thank Voboda and Carrie Finnegan, especially for the invitation. And I want to thank these incredible students. This has been, I have an easy part because I just get to work with the best students for a few days, which is a complete joy. The people that really deserve recognition are all of the orchestra directors throughout the state. If I can ask them to stand so we can thank them. Thank you for lending me your children for a few days. This is Rhapsody for Orchestra by Toyama.